Zach Jonas is setting the world on fire with his custom-made knives. Forging, hammering, grinding, polishing, creating exquisite blades and handles from design to finish.
It sounds simple, but just the act of taking raw materials, raw, unremarkable materials, a block of wood and a piece of steel, and turning it into not only something that is useful, but also something that is beautiful.
A master of his craft, Zach's knives are functional, yes, but they're also works of art. Zach has earned the rank of Master Bladesmith, a prestigious title held by fewer than 150 people worldwide, a rare honor bestowed by the American Bladesmith Society.
It's a really, really high standard of work, and I hasten to add, it's not like the goal that everyone should have in knife making. It's not what everyone's doing it for. For me, it was a matter of personal achievement.
His fascination with knives started when he was a young boy.
When I was, I think, about 10 years old, I stole one of my mom's paring knives.
Nothing particularly special about that knife, just a random paring knife with a rubber handle in the kitchen drawer.
I took it and I hid it under the couch in the basement, and I would take it out and look at it from time to time, just kind of admire it and think about how cool it was.
The powerful allure of the blade stuck with him. After college, he signed up for a knife-making class with a renowned bladesmith.
I showed up to that class totally green. I did not know who J.D. Smith was. I did not know that he was an American Bladesmith Society master smith and one of the best knife makers in the world.
Zach was hooked, took the class back-to-back 8 times, and eventually became an apprentice, then a journeyman smith, on his way to master smith. His days are spent inside his 3,600-square-foot workshop on an old bison farm in Warner, powering away at the forge and anvil, the press and hammer, the grinder and polisher, his blades made of high carbon steel.
If I'm making Damascus, which is mostly what I do, I'll take that bar of steel and cut it up into shorter, usually 6-inch sections.
He makes these stunning patterns by stacking a number of bars, creating layers, heats them up in the forge, and then heads to the hammer.
Hit it with a really big hammer, and that causes it to fuse and become a solid piece of steel.
Another pattern created by twisting the hot metal. Once the blade is forged, onto the grinding room. The belts, essentially sandpaper, smooth and even out the steel. The make or break point involves hardening the steel.
And that'll do it. That's a hardened steel blade now.
Zach's most popular knife, the 7-inch Damascus chef knife.
The Damascus steel just has that romance. It has that wow factor and the punch that you're not going to see in just a plain old piece of steel.
Each knife has a maker's mark. On one side, MS for Master Smith. The flip side, Zach's signature, the letter Z. The handles are made of wood sourced from trees all over the world. Cut, carved, smoothed, and polished, then connected to the blade.
Once I've put the final edge on the knife, I always like to do a little test with some standard printer paper.
Whoa. I would say that's sharp.
Just to prove the point, he cuts his arm hair.
Oh. Oh no. Oh my gosh. Stop.
Most of Zach's knives end up in the $500 to $1,000 range, but he's designed some for 10 times that.
If someone wants a chef's knife with diamonds and gold and fossilized mammoth ivory for the handle, I'll do it. That'll be a $50,000 knife.
And he's had some crazy requests, like the customer who commissioned a Roman-style gladius sword. This is the first sword Zach ever made, a medieval arming sword.
Oh, it's heavy.
It's surprising, isn't it?
Yes.
He does a little experiment, having me hold 2 swords.
Which one's heavier?
This one is heavier.
Believe it or not, that one weighs 3 times as much.
He says it's all about the balance and how it's positioned in your hand.
One of the most common things people say when they pick up my chef's knives is, oh, it's so light. And my chef's knives are actually heavier than most commercial chef's knives, but they're balanced properly.
Zach appeared on the popular History Channel reality show, Forged in Fire. He was eliminated in the first round, but loved the experience.
It's a really cool show. I'm thrilled that it exists because it has boosted the awareness of my craft tremendously.
Maybe too much. He's booked out on orders for a year. The best place to see Zach's work is his website or at the League of New Hampshire Craftsmen's Fair in Mount Sunapee. You can also catch him again this year at the prestigious Smithsonian Craft Show in the nation's capital.
It's definitely my calling. It's what I love to do. I'm not curing cancer, but I love making knives.